There are going to be times with every media project that you need to take an asset such as an audio file or a video file and change it from one format to another, such as from a QuickTime movie to an FLV file, or you need to compress it so that you can save space and load time for certain projects. So we'll go ahead and jump into this and I'll show you how it works, and then we'll talk about the whys and whens to do this. So in this Adobe Media Encoder program, and there are other encoders out there, but this one comes with the Adobe Suite, so why not use it? I'm going to go ahead and click Add Source, and it'll ask me what file I want to change. So I have an M4A file right here, which is an audio file, and then I have a QuickTime movie here. So let's start with the audio. And right now, it's going to say it's going to turn it into an MP3 and what preset it's going to use and where it's going to put the new file. Let's take a look at this original audio file. I'll do Command-I, and it is originally 9.8 megabytes, and we want to make it smaller without losing too much quality so that we still have a good project. Now, as I click on this drop-down menu here, you can see there are a couple of different formats that I can choose from. These are actually mostly video, and we're going to just leave MP3 for this audio file. And then we have a bunch of presets here. For MP3, you only have three options, but if you were to choose something like H.264 for a video file, you would have, 20, 30 different presets. If you don't know which one to use, it's not going to hurt anything for you to actually experiment and choose all three. So this one I'm going to make 128, and I'll click on the output file name, and it's going to put it in the exact same place that the original file was located, and I'm going to name this one 128 Paradise, and then click Save. And I can come up here to this Add Output and do two more and change each of these to a different preset. So this one I can call 192 Paradise, and finally 256. Okay, so these are all ready to go. I'm going to hit play. And now we can see it encoding down here. You're going to see the three different files and their progress bars down here. If this was a video, you'd see a preview of the video at 12 seconds in, 14 seconds in, etc. And this bar is going to be all three projects at once. So this is how much time I have remaining. So then you hear a little chime telling you that it's done. And now you can see on my desktop that I have my original Paradise file, and then I have three MP3 files. So I'll go ahead and highlight those and do Command-I again. This is our original, it's 9.8 megabytes. The 128 is 4.4 megabytes, 192 is 6.7, and 256 is 8.9. So I can listen to all three of these files and decide which one is going to work best for my project in terms of quality. And I have already listened to these files before I started this video, and I don't really notice any difference, so it's going to be better for me to do the smaller file size, and you're going to just have to play around depending on your project and what you're trying to accomplish. So let's see how this works with video. I'll go ahead and do a new output and choose my video and click open, and all of a sudden you can see this little audio icon, and now we have a video icon. And this is where we can just take the audio straight from the video, but for right now I can turn it into an FLV file, and I can choose different presets. So if it's going to go on a mobile device or a web-enabled device, then I could do that there. And again, I can change the file name, and I can change these to, let's say, H.264, and now you're going to see a ton of different options. So Android phones, Apple TV, Vimeo, YouTube, it has all kinds of settings for you. It didn't bring up settings automatically that would be perfect for broadcast TV or DVD and Blu-ray, because this file is actually a very small file. It's originally 10.9 megabytes, but the dimensions of it is 698 by 949, so that's not going to work for a regular size TV. If I put a bigger file in here, let's say one of my screen recordings, which are big and full size, it's going to take the last preset and the last format that I used, But now if I come in here, I can actually go to, let's say, TV broadcast, and I can do 1080i to 29.97. Double click, and then it's going to add it here. So this helps you to understand which presets would work best for which format. So hopefully that helps you understand how to convert your files from one format to another, or to actually compress them and make their file size a lot smaller.